Welcome to Light Tutorials. Cameras and other devices have limitations in their naming conventions of files. It is worth looking through the settings of your devices and any software you use to import your files to amend the naming structure to your purposes. Renaming hundreds or thousands of files manually is not a reasonable proposition for most people. We will use the task automation tool, Windows PowerShell, to rename multiple files at once. It is included with most Windows packages, but is available for Linux and Mac also, via a free download from Microsoft, at the link shown and in the description below. You can open PowerShell through Windows search. It will open with the pathway of your default drive. You will need to type CD to set location, space, and in quotes, enter the pathway of your chosen folder. You can copy the address by right-clicking on it and selecting Copy Address as Text. Paste it and then press Enter. You can open PowerShell with your folder pathway automatically. In the folder that you wish to rename your files, hold down the Shift key and right-click with your mouse. Select the option Open PowerShell window here, or type in the address bar PowerShell and press Enter. It is advisable to make copies of all the files you want to rename and store them in a separate folder in case of a mistake. Furthermore, batch renaming should happen before import to the Lightroom catalog to avoid complications later. We will replace the letters CER with camera. I will explain briefly what each part of the command does so that you will be able to amend them for your own purposes. We will start with DIR, which selects the files from the said folder, space, pipe symbol, the capital I-shaped symbol, often found with the backslash key. It tells PowerShell to take the output of one command, selecting the files in the folder, and pass it as the input to the next command, which will be to give them a new name. Then space, rename, hyphen, item, space, hyphen, new name, space, open curly brackets, dollar sign, underscore, dot, name, which is to use all the files in the folder. Then space, hyphen, replace, space, in quotes, CER, comma, in quotes, camera, close curly brackets, which will replace CER with camera, then press enter. CER will now be replaced with camera in every file name in our folder. To replace the spaces in the file names with an underscore, we will repeat the code we just used by pressing the up arrow on our keyboard. Move the cursor by using the arrow keys on your keyboard and backspace or delete what you want to replace. Simply change the code to represent what you want to change from and to hit enter. Spaces have now been replaced with underscores. We could remove the underscore altogether and replace it with nothing, which will be open and close double quotes. To add a prefix, something at the beginning of the file name, we will remove the replace part of our code. And before the dollar symbol, we will type prefix in quotation marks, space, the plus symbol, and space again. Remember to close the curly brackets. This will add the word prefix to the beginning of every file name. If you have a scenario where you already have something at the beginning of some file names, but not all of them, we would amend the previous command to include after dir, space, hyphen, the word exclude, space, and in quotation marks the prefix you want to avoid, followed by an asterisk or star symbol, which is a wildcard and represents anything. Close quotation marks. This will add our prefix to every file, excluding those that already have it. If we want to add something to the end of a file name, we will remove our exclusion clause and our prefix. Change name to base name to add to the file name and not the extension, like .doc for Word or .jpg for an image. Then space, plus sign, space, and the word suffix in quotations, space, plus sign, dollar sign, underscore, dot extension. The word suffix has been added to the end of all our file names. In another situation, we might want to remove the leading zeros, but only the first two. But if we just replace them with nothing, we will remove the other double zeros in the name as well. To get around this, we will remove just the first two characters in the file name. We will start with dir, space, and our pipe symbol again, space, percent sign, which is for each object, space, open curly brackets, space, REN, which renames an item, space, dollar sign, underscore, space, dollar sign, underscore, dot name, dot substring, open brackets, 2, close brackets, space, close curly brackets. This will loop through each file and start the file name after the first two characters. If we want to remove the last four characters of a file name, we can reuse the code from our suffix by pressing the up arrow twice. We will remove our reference to the suffix, and after base name, enter dot substring, open brackets, 0, comma, dollar sign, underscore, dot base name, dot length, minus 4, close brackets. This will take the full length of the file name, starting from the beginning, but dropping the last four characters and preserving the extension as mentioned beforehand. You will need to adapt these commands based on your own requirements, so it is advised to copy some files into a separate folder and test it out to be sure you're getting the results you require. I hope this helped you. Thank you for watching.